Good morning and welcome to a new session. A very, very interesting session. Rotations of a string. Concept is very interesting and innovative too. So first, so left shift is shifting n characters or n number of characters from left to right. Okay, this is definition of left shift. From left to left hand to right hand. Okay, now so take a string with the process of deriving a formula. Now shift two characters from left to right. So after shifting, what do you get? So new string is s1 equal to two characters to the end. So what are remaining characters? Remaining characters, n colon, these are remaining characters. So if you take out 2, the printing should start from this. This is character 2, this is character 0, character 1, okay? Plus, the shifted characters have to be added at the right end. So what are shifted characters? From 0 to n, okay? Now this is left shift. Okay, so two characters are shifted to the right from left. Okay, watch out, we are in the process of deriving an important formula. Now let n is length of s. Okay, now shift n characters from left to right. Okay, n characters from left to right. Now do we shift? Let us do it. And shift n characters from left to right, shifting one at a time. So for I in range character 1 to character n, okay, shift one at a time. Say again, say s1 is equal to s I colon plus s colon I. Okay, S colon I. Sorry. Now print. Say print. Let us see what happens. For I in range. So let us quarantine it. Let us quarantine this part of code. Okay? See what happens. So this is shifting by 1, shifting by 2, shifting by 3, 4, 5. After shifting 5 characters, you got back your original character, your original string. What does it mean? If you rotate it n times, that is length of a string, then you get original character. Okay, length is 5. If you rotate by 5, you get original character. If you rotate by 6, it is rotating by 1 character. So hope you are in the process of deriving a formula. The formula is say read the string to be rotated, to be shifted. Now n is number of characters which you want to shift from left to right. Okay, then number of characters to be shifted, set D is equal to n modulus length of string. If n is 5, 0 displacements. If n is 6, 1 displacement. If number of characters are 5. Okay, now don't worry, this is not corona. Now the new string is equal to old string. So D added to D to N at the end, start to D at the beginning. Okay, and print new string. Now the string is, this is a string. I want to shift one character or two characters to right. Okay, fine. Now I want to rotate, I want to shift, say five characters. Sorry, string is DB now. I want to shift five characters. What happened? D is zero. Okay. So we should add one more here. If D not equal to zero, not D greater than zero. Okay. Right, then only shiftings are possible. If D equal to zero, there is no shift at all. Okay, so you will be printing your original string itself. Fine. So shift five characters from left to right. Okay, no shift at all. Now shift seven characters. Shift seven characters, nothing but shifting two characters. Okay, shift 22 characters, or do rotate, do shifting 22 times, nothing but two times. Okay, so this is the formula. If you want to shift something, if number of rotations are n, then actual number of displacements are n mod length. Okay, hope you understand it. Now let us extend this to right shift. Say right shift, shifting n characters from right to left. Okay, how it is done? The result is S1. The characters at the right side, how many n characters? Okay, so this is minus n to n. You shift them to first, add them to, what are the characters up to minus n? Two minus n. Okay, two minus n. This is right shift. Okay, now print. Say print as well. Let us bring. Let us take the string as TV down, and three characters from right to left. So what do you get? REAO TV. Fine. Three characters REAO to the right. Okay. Let us check it. TV now, three characters. Hope you understand it. Now, eight characters. let us check, say 5 characters. Same as original string. Okay. If it is 8 characters, then what should be done? Say d is equal to n modulus length of string. How many shiftings? D number of shiftings. Okay. So if you take 8. How many are effectively shifted? Only 3. Okay. So I hope you understand it. Now, one more concept. That is net displacement. If left and right are done together. Left and right are done together. Okay, now let us take a string. Say A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Let's take 10 characters. 6, I, J, K. Okay. What is now left shifts? Say 3. Okay. Right shifts by 4 or 5. Okay, so S1 is result after left shift. What is this? Yes. Plus yes colon n. Okay, this is left shift. So what is right shift? Well, let us print it first. Print left shift. Okay. Now right shift. So you move 3 characters. What happens? A, B, C will go here. Okay. Let us print it first. So A, B, C will go to the end. So let me correct. Now. S2. This is right shift. How many characters? R characters. So how to do it? Minus R till end plus start to minus R. Okay. So print S2. What happened? Sorry. I'll do one thing. I'll do in sequence. I'll take result of left shift as input to right shift. So what happened? Carefully observe it. What is the net result? Let us do one more thing. Let us print original string as well. Let us print original string as well. So print original string. This is original string A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay. This is shifting 3 to right. Okay. This is shifting 5 to left. Actually, we ended with only net shifting is only 2. So what does it mean? Shifting 3 to right, shifting 5 to left. Nothing but shifting 2 to the right. Okay. So what does it mean? S3 is equal to, so let net displacement is equal to R minus L. Okay. Let S3 is equal to S N colon plus S colon N. Okay. Now print S3. You can see that S3 is R minus N. No, this is shifting right. So this is minus N and this is also minus N. Okay. Now. I will have this output at the beginning of the screen so that you will have a clear idea. Let us run it again. Now see here. See what is S2? S2 is shifting 3 and 5. Okay. What is S3? Shifting 2. So this is equal to 2 shiftings. 3 left shift, 5 right shift is equal to 2 right shift. Is equal to 2 right shift. Hope you understand it. Okay. Now, let us have a bigger problem. Title is shift or rotation of characters in a string. Okay. Now, given a string. Perform the following rotations. And find out. Perform the following shifts and find out. The final position of characters. Okay. So bear with me for spellings. I'm not good at keyboard. Given a string, perform the following shifts. Say first 0, 0, 13. Next. The string is say 1, 20 followed by 0, 15 followed by 0, 10. Okay. Now, so 0 stands for left shift and 1 stands for right shift. Okay. Now, effective number of shifts. Effective number of, say, left shifts is equal to, let n is length of string. Okay. What number of characters of string? Effective number of left shifts is equal to. So 13 modulus n plus 15 modulus n plus 10 modulus n. Okay. So 13 modulus n, if it is 5, this is 3. Now let it be say 14. Let it be 11. Okay. And let it be 24. Let it be 12. This is 12. This is 11. And this is 10. Okay. 12 mod 5 is 2. 11 mod 5 is 1. So effectively it is 3. Okay. Effectively it is 2 plus 1 plus 0 equal to 2. Now, effective number of right shifts is equal to, how many right shifts are there? Only one, that is 24 mod n. N is 5, so this is 4. Okay. Now, total number of shifts is equal to number of right shifts minus number of left shifts. Okay, this is 4 minus 3 equal to 1. Okay, so total number of right shifts is equal to this. Okay, so what is solution? Solution is shifting t beta by 1. So net result is V R A O T. Okay, this is net result. So let us do it. Let us take the inputs. First, read the string. Okay. So total number of shifts are 4. So n is the number of shifts. So how many shifts are there? 4. N is number of shifts. Okay. Now read the shifts for i in range. How many? N. Okay. Now, shift is equal to comma separated values. Input split at comma, split at comma, and map to integer. Okay, and then list. Then list. Okay. Now, so number of displacements of left. This is shift 1 modulus length of string. Okay, so if shift 0 is 0, that is left shift. Okay, so let us call this as number of displacements. If it is left, number of displacements are negative. Okay. Is this clear? Now, let total displacements to right equal to 0. total displacement right is 0. If left, minus. If right, no change. Then total plus number of shifts. Okay. Now what is the final result? The result is equal to right shifts by how many total? What is the string name? Yes minus total colon plus yes colon minus total. Okay, and print the result. So this is one of the coding challenges in lead code. Very interesting concept. Made simple. So this is the result expected. And these are the inputs. Okay, let us run it. String is TV now. Number of shifts are 4. So what is first shift? First shift is 0, 12. Left 12 to left. What happened? Invalid return. Repeated comma. Sorry for that. So let us repeat it. So string name, number of displacements. First one, left 12 left, 24 right, 11 left, 10 left. Okay. So what happened? I'm sorry. This is OTVRE. 1 to left. Okay. So what is the result? Fine. So net result is one right shift. Net result is one right shift. Okay. So I hope you understand it. So what has to be done? To find out effective shifts, you should take not with length. Okay, left shifts are made negative and right shifts are made positive. You find out net shifts. Okay. So try doing it on your own. Very interesting problem, I suppose. And this is coding challenge of one of the famous coding platforms, LeetCode. Okay, so IT companies are constantly looking for such coding challenges from coding platforms. So do it on your own to understand it. Okay, so please like it if you like it, and please do subscribe. Okay, I'm looking forward for your subscriptions. Thank you.